I want to be clear from the start that the tools I'm going to show you do not use AI in any way, and I can guarantee two things. First of all, you have not heard of these before, and second of all, you are going to be furious that you didn't know about them. You see, we've all had this situation where we find a JPEG image online that we need to use for whatever reason, but of course, when we look at it, it's got this horrible JPEG compression all over it. And it's especially bad for screenshots and the text in them, where even at JPEG 90% quality, the artifacts are still there, and at 50% quality, it's just horrific. But I'm going to show you how, with just a single command from one of these tools, which by the way are free and run on your local computer, you can turn this into this in a matter of seconds. I couldn't believe it. Now, if you search online for JPEG artifacts removal, you'll find results. A lot of them are AI, but none of them work very well. Even with Adobe Photoshop, there are neural filters, and specifically one for JPEG artifact removal, but even using that, especially on screenshots, it leaves behind a bunch of blotchiness around the text you can see. But then I learned about a couple of free command line tools that, in my opinion, are total game changers. Specifically, they are called JPEG Quant Smooth and JPEG 2PNG. They both are the same idea generally, but might work better on different types of pictures. Here's another example on a screenshot at a more reasonable 80% quality. And with that, using JPEG to PNG specifically, you can go from this to this, with basically all of the artifacts gone. It's insane. If you compare that to Photoshop's neural filters result, it's like night and day. Now, if you compare it to the original uncompressed screenshot image, obviously there are some very slight differences. But I mean, if you had that original one, you'd be using that anyway, so it doesn't matter. And to be clear, it's not applying any kind of blurring or filtering or anything like that. It actually uses the information that's in the JPEG file itself and just kind of decompresses it in a way that's more optimal to remove the artifacts. I know that sounds vague, I'll try to explain it better later, but the main takeaway is that you're really not going to be sacrificing many details, if at all, like you might with some kind of blur filter. And the main reason you don't see it used everywhere is because it does take longer, potentially a few seconds. So if every image viewer were to use this, it would take seconds to open up every single image, it wouldn't make sense. So what I'll do is go over the basic usage of these tools and then some of the options and settings that I found work best on different types of images. Like for how to get screenshots looking the best specifically is what I cared the most about. Before getting to that though, something else that's really cool is today's sponsor, Ugreen, and two of their new products, the Ugreen Uno Charger 100 Watt and Ugreen Magnetic Wireless Power Bank. They both feature cute robot designs with TFT smart displays to not only show the battery level, but also fun charging status emojis, like the cool guy sunglasses emoji when charging is finished, a standby emoji, and I like this om nom nom chewing charging emoji, and there's a few more that appear. The 100 watt charger is both cute and versatile, with three USB-C and one USB-A ports, and it can indeed output the full 100 watts through a single port, either C1 or C2. And through any of the C ports, it can charge, for example, an iPhone 16 from 0 to 57% in 30 minutes. Of course, it can also charge devices from all four ports simultaneously while intelligently distributing load. Then there's the Uno 10,000 milliamp hour magnetic wireless power bank. Capable of 15 watt Qi2 magnetic fast charging, it can fully charge an iPhone 16 Pro 1.6 times. It features a built-in stand to prop up your phone while charging it and using it, and it has a 20 watt USB-C in-out charge port if you need it. There's more to the Ugreen Uno lineup to check out though, with more power banks, hubs, and cables, like this 100 watt USB-C cable that shows little eyes on the screen while it's charging. So visit the links in the description and check out the Ugreen Uno Charger 100 Watt, the Ugreen Uno Magnetic Wireless Power Bank, and the rest of the Uno lineup, as well as Ugreen's Black Friday and Cyber Monday deals going on. And with all that being said, let's continue. All right, so as for where to get these tools, I'll put the links to JPEG Quant Smooth and JPEG to PNG in the description. They're both open source and they're on GitHub. For JPEG to PNG though, I'm also gonna link a forked version that I made. Originally, there were some bugs in JPEG to PNG. Some people made pull requests that fixed the bugs, but the developer has not updated the project. So I just made a fork that added those patches in, and you can still run it the same otherwise. They're both command line tools, so you'd run it through command prompt. though for JPEG to PNG, you can actually just drag a file onto it and it'll run it with the default settings. And a pro tip, if you go to the Windows File Explorer address bar and just type in CMD, it'll open the command prompt to that directory. Now, as for which one is better, it definitely depends on whether it's like a graphical illustration or screenshots versus a photograph. For screenshots and that sort of thing, I definitely would say that JPEG to PNG is better. You can see here, like around the text, it just seems to remove a little bit more of the blotchiness. And also I found with JPEG to PNG, using the parameter -W0 for weight zero also improves it for screenshots, although it might seem to smooth it a bit too much if you're doing it for a photograph. Also, with JPEG to PNG, the number of iterations, the default is 50, and I usually set it to like 100. I think beyond that, it's like diminishing returns. And what I found for a JPEG to PNG is, even if it's not a screenshot, if it's a photograph, if it's highly compressed and it has like a ton of artifacts, then it also probably is going to be better than JPEG Quant Smooth. However, looking at JPEG Quant Smooth, this one does seem to be a bit better for photographs that are moderately compressed specifically. Like in this example where I have this photo, which is at 80% quality, you can just start to see a lot of the blockiness if you zoom in. This seems to be the best situation for using this one. It just seems to retain a little bit more of the sharpness than JPEG to PNG. Now, one option to definitely be aware of with JPEG Quant Smooth is the Q quality option. I would not set this to 6, I would set it to 5. And that's because based on the documentation and what I've seen, 6 quality actually tries to upsample the color information. So it's kind of like trying to invent additional information that wasn't there before, whereas quality 5 just works with what is already there. Of course, you can try quality 6, and if it does end up looking better, maybe for photographs especially, you can still try that. And just to experiment, I created a couple batch files that I can link in the description, where for each of the programs, it'll basically make a whole bunch of combinations of the iterations and like quality or weight parameters that you can kind of see which combination you like the best. Now, as for a more technical explanation of how these tools work, a lot of it is way above my head, but there is a pretty good explanation on the JPEG to PNG project page. But from my understanding, when you go to compress an image with JPEG, there's several steps, and one of those steps is to round some kind of value. And then when image viewers go to uncompress the image, they just use those rounded values. Say it's 1.0, but that could potentially have originally been like 0.8 or 0.9. So what I think these programs do is basically try different values, and then I guess analyzes how that affects the pixel values around it, and then tries to find ones that minimize some kind of pattern that it's looking for that signifies that there's artifacts, and just tries to minimize it. But if you have a better explanation, by all means, leave it in the comments. So yeah, I would be very curious if you guys had known about this, and if you do any graphic design or, you know, presentations with screenshots, I think you'll definitely find this helpful. I still can't believe people upload screenshots in JPEG, especially since a lot of times the JPEG is bigger than a PNG for that kind of image. So definitely let me know what you think down in the comments. Thanks again to Ugreen for sponsoring. Be sure to visit the links in the description and check out the Ugreen Uno Charger 100 Watt, the Ugreen Uno Magnetic Wireless Power Bank, and the rest of their Uno device lineup and their Black Friday deals going on. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I made a really cool tool in Windows that I think is one of the most useful ones I've made so far. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.